Hello and welcome to this tutorial about my three favorite panoramic shooting techniques. My name is Florian and I run the website pano.ie. You're very welcome to visit it. Now most of the panoramas on that website are shot using one of the following three techniques. They all involve an 8mm fisheye lens. This is a full frame camera, so the first technique I'm going to show you is with the 8mm fisheye on the full frame camera. The second and third technique will involve a crop camera because not everybody has a full frame camera. Now as with most panoramic shooting techniques, you want to set your camera to manual mode. That is manual exposure, manual focus, and manual white balance. I set up the camera to roughly match the current lighting situations, which is quite dark actually, so I'm running at ISO 800, but not to worry. So the trick about the first technique, which is called the philopod pitch variation technique, is that you're actually not using a tripod. You want to be as fast as possible. But how can you rotate your camera around the nodal point without a tripod? Well, the trick here is that you attach the front of the camera, if the camera focuses, it focuses there. As you can see, there is a piece of string attached to the front of the lens. And at the end of that string, there is a coin, something just to weigh the string down. So this string and that piece on the bottom here is going to help me keep reference, keep the camera in the same spot as I turn around to take the different pictures. So let's start. The idea of the philopod pitch variation technique on a full frame camera is that you take four pictures, one in each direction, and that you're varying the pitch slightly up and down between shots. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to unfold my string. I'm going to hang it above the same spot on the ground, and I'm not so much going to look at the camera. I'm more going to look at the string and the coin so that it stays above the same point on the ground. At the moment, I have the camera tilted slightly down. So I'm going to take the first picture here. Then I'm going to turn 90 degrees, tilt the camera slightly up, keep the coin above the same spot on the ground, take the second picture. Same thing, tilting the camera slightly down again, I'm going to take another picture. And then the last of the four pictures, I'm going to point the camera slightly up again and take another picture. There we go. That's it. If I didn't talk that much, I would have done this in less than 20 seconds. And as I will show you in the second part of this tutorial, I will have a fully spherical panorama with no tripod in it. So what do you do if you don't have a full frame camera but a crop camera like this one here? Well, I'm still using the same fisheye lens and I'm also going to take four pictures. However, I'm going to take an additional two pictures, one up and one down. But the idea remains the same. Again, with the string hanging about the same point on the ground, I'm going to take four pictures. This time, however, I'm going to keep the camera straight, so just pointing straight at the horizon level. So here's image number one. Number two, number three, four. Now, carefully tilting the camera upwards, trying to keep it steady above the same point, I take one picture up and then taking the cabling away, trying to stay above the same spot, I'm going to take one picture down. That's it. Now we have taken six pictures again. If I wasn't babbling on that much, I could have done this in less than 20 seconds again. Now, if I am inside a dark room or a cathedral or something and I can't use the string technique because the exposure times would be too long, I'm going to use a tripod. So just for completeness sake, I'm going to show you how to use a tripod and a panoramic head. So here I am back again with a tripod and a panoramic head. This is the Nodal Ninja 3, which is perfectly fine for small cameras like this. It's compact, it's lightweight, it's everything you'll need. Now, setting up the tripod, what I'll try to do is keep a small footprint when you look down. So I'm going to try to keep the legs fairly close together, but that it's still sturdy enough. I'm going to pull out the center column all the way up. All the way up. There we go. I should have done this before. Anyway, I'm just going to make sure the bubble level is roughly in the center. There we go. So the idea now is I'm going to take seven pictures, one in each compass direction, one up, one down, and one from a slightly different angle, just so I can remove the tripod afterwards. So here we go. I've got the camera set to a much smaller ISO and to 2 second delay mode, so there's no shake in it. So I'm going to take the first picture, and take the second picture, rotating 90 degrees. Third picture, again 90 degrees apart. The last picture, going back to my initial position, but now tilting the camera vertically up, getting my head out of the way. There's the church bell, pointing it vertically down, just as a reference for the second shot I'm going to take off the ground. Getting out of the way. Now, the last one is a bit special. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to cover the area that is at the moment is obstructed by the tripod itself. So I try to remember a spot above the ground. If I had anything in my pockets, I would put something on the ground. I don't have anything, so I'm just going to remember the spot on the ground, and I'm trying to put the camera above that spot. Now again, the thing here is we're having long exposure time, so I still need to use the tripod. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tilt the camera at an angle, and then I'm going to tilt it back like so, trying to keep it roughly above that spot on the ground. I'm going to pull out that extra leg, and then I'm going to stand on it. That way I can have the picture off that ground with the camera stabilized. So there we go. Here's the last picture. Now that's it. I took 7 pictures all around in each direction, one up, one down, and another one from a slightly different perspective to remove the tripod. So there we go, that's it. These are the 3 techniques that I mostly use. If I want obviously a higher resolution panorama, I'm going to use a longer focal length lens because that'll increase the resolution, but I'd also need more shots. Anyway, I hope you've learned something today. As you can see, especially with the first technique, if you're lucky to have a full frame camera, you can take a panorama in no time at all. Thank you very much for your attention. I'll see you at the next tutorial when we're trying to put one of the 3 panoramas together in PT GUI. Thanks.